streaming video, of course, is up across the board, from Netflix to Hulu to Disney Plus and all the rest. YouTube is seeing a big spike in views of news videos, this Bloomberg headline citing a thirst for virus updates. There are a lot of facets to YouTube. Mis- and disinformation is a problem on that platform as well. I spoke with YouTube CEO Susan Wojcicki for her first interview since the pandemic really started to spread worldwide about the changes that YouTube has made to address the surge in viewership.
We've served billions of impressions across our network that come from all the different public health organizations and made sure that people understand what are the resources. I never thought we'd have so many videos of hand washing, for example, but that's just one example, but we've served so many different areas to make sure that users are getting the right information. We've actually seen a 75% increase in the news coming from authoritative sources since the beginning of 2020. So we've seen a lot of demand there. But then we also—
What does that mean? That means an increase in video views for those?
Yeah, and so we talk about that as raising authoritative information. But then we also talk about removing information that is problematic. You know, of course, anything that is medically unsubstantiated, so people saying like, take vitamin C, take turmeric, like those are all will cure you. Those are the examples of things that would be a violation of our policy. Anything that would go against World Health Organization recommendations would be a violation of our policy. And so remove is another really important part of our policy.
So you're not just putting the truth next to the lie, you're taking the lie down. That's a pretty aggressive approach.
Well, we do remove, across YouTube in non-pandemic times, information that is a violation of our policy. And we've had community guidelines since the very beginning of YouTube, and we've always, anything that is a violation of our policy, we do remove it. And what was really unique about this was just how fast moving the COVID-19 crisis was. And so we've had to make numerous policy changes all within a really short period of time to be able to make sure that we stayed abreast of the changes. So for example, just recently there was a theory that 5G was causing coronavirus symptoms. Now, no established health organization says that 5G is the source of the issue. And so that quickly deemed that a violation of our policies with COVID-19 and remove that content.
Yeah, everyone's YouTube is different. Are there certain videos that basically everybody has seen because they are so important or they are from such authoritative sources?
Well, we definitely saw a really high click-through and all the different public health information that we made available. This crisis has just moved so quickly. I think that's what the speed of it has taken away everyone's breath in terms of how quickly we move from just having a few infections, right, to having large parts of the world being under quarantine. And we certainly have seen how our users have changed. So first starting with just really basic information about what was coronavirus, then we really focused on the stay at home messages and got that. And now, really interestingly, we're seeing a lot of users come to us and want to know about life under quarantine. And so we see a lot of interest in things like exercise at home, like how do I fix my dishwasher? How do I fix my freezer? How do I give myself a haircut when I'm in quarantine? And so we've definitely seen an evolution across our platform in all these different ways.
Do you think this crisis has caused YouTube to change in ways that'll be long-term?
I certainly have seen changes. I think in many ways we've seen an acceleration of our digital lives. We used to see movies, science fiction movies, where we would talk about kids going to school in the future, where they would be, on screens and they would be going to a school that wasn't really in their neighborhood. And that seemed like science fiction. And now we have all of our kids, or so many of them are have some kind of digital school program now, because schools are closed, sadly. And so that is certainly an acceleration. I think with public health, we probably would have gotten there in a couple of years. But certainly this has been a big acceleration of realizing the important need of working with established public health organizations to get the right information online to users. And we're seeing that opportunity.